Myself, Dr. Deepika Patel, tutor, microbiology department. Today, topic is introduction of mitozoa, cystode, T. solium, T. sajanata, and T. later. It is the part of parasitology. Now, which are the learning objectives that we will see in this topic? Causative agents of these parasites, life cycle, pathogenesis, clinical features or complications. After that, we will see about epidemiology, laboratory diagnosis of the causative agents, treatment of that agents and prevention, how to prevent the infection of these parasites. Now first, introduction to metazoa. Metazoa is from phylum. It is the phylum metazoa. Definition is it is motile, multicellular, heterotrophic organism that develops from embryos. However, metazoans like spongians and some cnidarians have become sessiles, but they still have motile larvae in their life cycles. Their body cells are generally differentiated into tissue and organs. Now, metazoans are diploid organisms in which the haploid gametes are formed by meiosis. The gametes are produced within a multicellular sex organs. Now, the important features on the basis of which metazoan hierarchy is decided are three. That are the symmetry, coelom, and metamerism. After that, we will see about the cystodes. Cystodes are classified into two types. First one is a systemic classifications. In systemic classification, first phylum is a platyhelminths. Now class is Cystoidea. Subclass is Eucystoda. And order of these phylum platyhelminthes cystodes are that are two types: Pseudophyllidea and Cyclophyllidea. Now first, after that, classification which is based on habitat of parasites that are of two types, intestinal cystodes, and second one is a somatic or tissue cystodes. For examples, it includes Diphyllobothrium species. Second one is a Tinea solium and Tinea sajanata that causes intestinal tinniasis. Hymenolepis species are the other examples. It causes intestinal cystoidosis infections. Now, second one, that is a somatic tissue cystodes. Larval forms are found in the human or in their muscles or organs. For examples, it includes Tinea solium causing cysticercosis, Tinea multiceps. Third one is the Echinococcus species, the agent of hydrated disease affecting liver. Now, systemic classification of cystodes that are the we already explained. I have already explained about the order Pseudophyllidea and Cyclophyllidea. They are classified into family and genus. Pseudophyllidea contains family Diphyllobothridea and genus Diphyllobothrium spirometra. Cyclophyllidea order that contains family Tinidia. Tinidia contains genus of Tinea echinococcus. Now, Hymenolepipedia contains genus Hymenolepis. Diphyllodidea contains genus Diphyllodium. Now, morphology of cystodes. It contains adult worms, eggs. First one is a adult worm that is found in intestine of man. As described in figure, it contains hooklets on rostellum. Suckers, there are three suckers. After that, it contains neck region. Then it contains strobila. It is also called as a body or trunk. They are classified in three parts. That are the immature proglottids, mature proglottids, and gravid proglottids. Now, shape of the adult worm, it is a long, segmented, flattened, dorsoventrally like worms, hence also called as a tapeworms. Now size of this organism adult worm is few millimeters to several meters. Body structure contains, as I have already explained, it contains head or scolex. Second one is a neck and third one is a strobila. Now, mature proglottids of two types of cystoids, pseudophyllidian and cyclophyllidian cystoids. It contains, in first one, pseudophyllidian cystoids, common genital pores are there. Then, seminal vesicles, it contains vagina, vas deferens, convoluted uterus, seminal receptacles, bilobed ovary, oviduct, vitelline ducts, vas efferentia and testicular follicles. Now, cyclophyllidian cystoids contains vas efferentia, vas deferens, serous sacs, common genital pore, vagina, branched uterus, testicular follicles, bilobed ovary, oviduct, Meles gland, vitelline gland and ootypes. Also it contains seminal vesicle. Now, eggs of these organisms. Eggs, as described in this figure, first one A is a pseudophyllidian cystoids. Second one is the egg of cyclophyllidian cystoids. C is cyclophyllidian cystoids after the loss of egg cells. Now, eggs are the released into the uterus following fertilization and fill the gravid proglottids. First one, that is egg of pseudophyllidian, it contains operculum at the top and at the end, knob is present. Second one is a cyclophyllidian cystoid. It contains eggshells, embryophore, embryo. In embryo, it contains three pairs of hooklets. C is eggs that is lost the eggshells. It contains embryophore, three pairs of hooklets. Figure shows larva that are the cyclophyllidian cystoids. A is cysticercus bovis, B is cysticercoid, C is cysticercus cellulosus, D is coenuous and E is of hydrated cyst. Larva is embryonated egg undergone further development from larva. Difference between the pseudophyllidian and cyclophyllidian cystoids. First point is scolex. In pseudophyllidian cystoids, it bears two growths. It is also called as a bothria. In cyclophyllidian cystoids, it bears four suckers. That are some species bear rostellum with hooklets. Second topic is which is differentiated by pseudophyllidian cystoids and pseudophyllidian cyclophyllidian cystoids is it is convoluted, rosetted shaped, unbranched, open at the uterine pole in pseudophyllidian cystoids. In cyclophyllidian cystoid, it is a branched and closed as a blind sac and it contains no uterine pole. In pseudophyllidian cystoid, genital pores are situated ventrally in the midline. In cyclophyllidian cystoid, it is situated at the laterally. In vitelline duct, in pseudophyllidian cystoid, it is scattered throughout the segments. In cyclophyllidian cystoid, vitelline gland is single mass behind the ovary. Eggs of the pseudophyllidian cystoids are covered by one layer. It is called as the egg cell. Freshly passed egg in a fishes are unembryonated. Eggs are operculated and the embryo is ciliated. In cyclophyllidian cystoid, eggs are covered by two layers. First one is an egg cell and second one is an embryo. Embryonated eggs that are from the beginnings. In eggs are not operculated like the pseudophyllidian cystoids and the embryo is not solvated. Larval form of the pseudophyllarian cystode is solid. Larval form of the cyclophyllarian cystodes contains bladder-like sac. Now, Diphyllobacterium species or D. latum. D. latum is the largest non-parasite found in the human intestine. It is also known as a feast tapeworm. Epidemiology of the D. latum. D. latum infection occurs worldwide. It is very rare in India. 3 cases of D. latum have been reported, D. latum infection, so far from South India. It is Vellore in 1998, in 2007 in Pondicherry, and 2011 in Karimannagar. Now, habitat of D. latum, small intestine, jejunum and duodenum. Morphology, in figure it is also shown, adult worm contain. It is the largest tapeworm infecting man, measuring up to 15 meters or more with over 3000 ploglotids. It consists of head, neck, body, or body. It is also called as a strobila. Strobila is more than 3000 segments divided into immature, mature and gravid segments. Mature segment is broader 10 to 20 mm, then longer 2 to 4 mm. And contains male and female both reproductive organs. Gravid segment of uterus is filled with egg which are discharged periodically through the uterine pore. Now eggs, that is already shown, its upper pole shows the operculum and lower pole shows no. Fertilized eggs are oval measuring 58 to 75 micrometer length and 40 to 50 micrometer width. Egg are operculated at the one end, bear a knob at the other end. Embryonated eggs contain hexacanth oncosphere lined by a ciliated membrane. Larva. Larva are, there are three larval stage. First stage larva is coracidium. Second stage larva is prosarcoid. Third stage larva is pleurosarcoid. Now life cycle. Definitive host is man. First intermediate host is cyclops and second intermediate host is fish. Now definitive host man acquire infection by ingestion of undercooked fish containing pleurosarcoid larva. That is the third stage larva. Then liberated in intestinal site and develop into the adult worm. It is shown in the figure. Adult worm attaches to mucosa of small intestine, then goes for the fertilization. After fertilization, eggs are released that are the operculated egg, and at the other side it is no. Now after 10 to 12 days, embryonated egg in fresh or marine water, that is the now it is fertilized, and coracidium in fresh or marine water, it is the first stage of larva that is present in the water. Then after 12 hours, coracidium in the body cavity of cyclops transform to prosarcoid larva, that is the second stage of larva. After 2 to 3 weeks, prosarcoid larva is appears. Then prosarcoid larva that is eaten by the feces, and presarcoid in feces is the second intermediate host. Fish is the second intermediate host. After 1 to 2 weeks, pleurosarcoid larva, that is the third stage larva in the muscle or viscera, which is infection by ingestion of undercooked fish or containing pleurosarcoid larva. Now cycle is repeated. Pathogenesis and clinical feature. Infection, most of that are asymptomatic, like abdominal discomfort, diarrhea, vomiting, weakness and weight loss, or rarely intestinal obstructions. Other one is a cholangitis or cholecystitis. Vitamin B12 deficiency is also present. that is dissociation of the vitamin B12 intrinsic factor complex with the gut lumen and leads to development of megaloblastic anemia. Lab diagnosis. In stool examination, we will see if infection is present, then egg of D. latum will be present. Characteristic of egg in the stool as they are the surrounded by egg cells and operculum at one end and a knob at the other end. Eggs are bile stained, do not float in the saturated salt of solution. Proglotids may be discharged in the stool in some cases. Other figure shows carmine stained gravid proglotids of D. latum. Treatment. Praziquantel is the highly effective drug, that is the drug of choice. Alternatively, we can give niclosamide, parenteral vitamin B12 to be given. Cyclophyllidian cystodes are Tinea species, Echinococcus species, Hymenolepis species. Now we will see about Tinea species. Classification of Tinea species. Tinea species that are pathogenetic to humans, they are classified into two types, Tinea saginata and Tinea solium. Tinea saginata is also called as a beef tapeworm and it causes intestinal tinniasis. T. solium, it is also called as a pork tapeworm and it does intestinal tinniasis and cysticercosis. Now, hosts are classified according to their species. Tinea species that are the in first one, definitive host is man. Intermediate host is cattle. Organ affected in pathogenesis is intestine. And disease caused by Tinea saginata is intestinal tinniasis. In T. solium, definitive host is man. Intermediate host are the pig and also man. Organ affected in intermediate host of pig is intestine. Disease caused by an intestinal infection, it is called as an intestinal tinniasis. In intermediate host of man, in T. solium, organ affected are muscles, central nervous system and eye. Disease caused by that is cysticercosis. Habitat. Adult worm of both resides in small intestine. Larva of T. solium reside and cystic lesion in the muscle, brain and eyes occur. Now, morphology. There are three forms of morphologically: adult worm, egg and larva. Figure shows hooklets on rostellum, sucker, neck region, immature proglotids, mature proglotids and gravid proglotids. All that proglotids parts that is commonly called as a strobila. Now, feature of T. saginata and T. solium. Adult worm. Length, T. saginata 4 to 6 meter or more. Length of T. solium 2 to 4 meter. So, T. saginata is longer. Head or scolex of T. saginata is large, quadrangular. Four suckers are present which may be pigmented. No rostellum or hooklets are present. In T. solium, small head and scolex are small and globular. Four suckers present. They are not pigmented. Bears rostellum with two rows of hooklets. It is also called as a arm tapeworm because it contains two rows of hooklets. Next are T. saginata are longer and in T. solium that are the shorter. Eggs of Tinea species in figure, it shows three pairs of hooklets in embryo. Embryo is covered by embryo 4 and then embryo 4 is covered by eggshell region. It is around 30 to 40 micrometer covered by two layers. Embryo or oncospore is present. Egg of species are similar. Larva of cysticercus. Tinea saginata, it is called as a cysticercus bovis, found in cattle's muscles, not in men. In men, It is a Tinea solium. It is called as a cysticercus cellulosis. Present in pig's muscle, also in man. Life cycle of T. saginata. In this, there are two hosts. One is definitive host. Definitive host is man. Intermediate host is cattle. Infective stage, that is a cysticercus bovis, and in man. And in cattle, it is eggs. Now, life cycle. Life cycle is present in man and cattle. First, man acquire infection by ingestion of undercooked beef containing cysticercus bovis. Then, scolex, that is exvaginates, and encroaches to intestine. Then, in intestine, it develops into the adult swarm in small intestine. Then, after 10 to 14 weeks, fertilization occurs and eggs are present in the feces. Now, cycle goes to the in cattles. Eggs are ingested by cattles. Oncosphere hatches out and penetrates in intestine. In circulations, it presents, and then cysticercus bovis in skeletal muscle, it goes likely that, and men acquire infection by ingestion of undercooked beef containing cysticercus bovis, cycle is repeated. Life cycle of T. solium depends on the disease. It is also is intestinal infection, intestinal tiniasis, and second one is a cysticercosis that is present in the muscle. Man, life cycle is man acquires infection by ingestion of undercooked pork containing cysticercus cellulosis. Now, scolex, exvaginates, and encroaches to the intestine, develop into the adult worm in small intestine. Then fertilization occur and eggs in the feces are present. Whole the cycle is present in the man. Now, in the pig, eggs are ingested in pigs. Then oncosphere hatches out and penetrate intestine. Then goes to the circulation, develop into the cysticercus in muscles. Then man acquires infection by ingestion of undercooked or pork containing cysticercus cellulosis. Now, other infection, cysticercosis in man occurs by external autoinfections and internal autoinfection. By external autoinfections, eggs are ingested by unhygienic personal habits. Then, internal autoinfections, eggs are thrown back to the stomach by reverse peristalsis. And oncospheres hatches out and penetrates into the intestine, then develops cysticercus in man in CNS, eye, and muscles. Then cysticercus in the muscle will eaten by the man, and cycle is repeated. Cysticercus bovis or cellulosis. Cysticercus, there are two types, cysticercus bovis in skeletal muscle and in man. In muscles, it is a small, as its figure is drawn, 6 to 9 mm, round, grayish-white, bladder-like worm containing invaginated scolex without hooklets. Now, in CNS, eye, and muscles, it is a 0.5 to 1.5 cm, spherical in shape, yellowish-white, outer bladder-like sac filled with vesicular fluid, inner chamber contain growing scolex with hooklets. Now, pathogenesis and clinical feature. In intestinal tiniasis, it is asymptomatic or passages of proglottids in their feces. Mild abdominal discomfort, loss of appetite, change in bowel habits, occasional obstruction by migrating proglottids happens and it causes appendicitis and cholangitis. Cysticercosis. Clinical features depends on cyst location in the body. Subcutaneous cysticercosis, muscular cysticercosis, ocular cysticercosis, and neurocysticercosis. In subcutaneous, it is a palpable nodules. In muscular, it is muscle pain and weakness. Ocular cysticercosis, it causes proptosis, diplopia, loss of vision. Now, neurocystic sarcosis, most common form, 60 to 90% of cases of cystic sarcosis, parasitic CNS infection of man and adult, onset epilepsy throughout the world. NCC, it is the short form of two types, parenchymal and extraparenchymal. In parenchymal, it involves parenchyma of the brain, and extraparenchymal sites are meninges, ventricles and spinal cord. Subarachnoid spaces, most common sites, and brain parenchyma. It can be asymptomatic to various manifestation like seizure, 70% of cases which happens by seizure. Hydrocephalus, increased intracranial pressure, chronic meningitis, focal neuralgia, deficits and psychological disorder and dementia. Clinical presentation may be variable and depend on the number of cystic sarcosis, location, size of the cyst, morphological stages of the cyst and the host immune response. Epidemiology in India. NCC is most common parasitic CNS infection of male. It causes epilepsy, late onset. Recent study with the help of CT and MRI suggests the disease burden in India is 18 to 31% of suspected cases of epilepsies. It appears to be more prevalent in various places like Bangalore, Delhi, Vellore, Bihar, UP, Pondicherry and Chandigarh. Laboratory diagnosis. In first one, intestinal tineasis, in stool examination, if detects eggs or proglottids. Features of proglottids in tinea saginata is number of proglottids are 1000 to 2000. In tinea solium infection, it is 800 to 1000. Uterus bears in 15 to 20 lateral branches. In tinea solium, uterus bears in 7 to 13 lateral branches. Lobes of ovary that are 2 in tinea saginata, no accessory lobe. And in tinea solium, there are 3 and 2 lobes with an accessory lobes. Testes in tinea saginata, that are the 300 to 400 follicles. In tinea solium, 150 to 200 follicles. Vaginal sphincter present in tinea saginata and absent in tinea solium. Expulsion of segments expelled singly in feces and in the solium, chains of 5 to 6 segments are present. B. Tinea specific antigen detection, that is the copro antigen in stool by ELISA. Advantage, it is the more sensitive and can detect carrier. Limitation is differentiation between tinea saginata and T solium infection. Antibody detection in serum by precipitation, agglutination, complement fixation test and ELISA. Limitation, cannot differentiation between present and past infection. Newer advances that are the recently immunoblot is developed for T solium specific antibodies and claims 95% sensitive and 100% specific. Molecular methods are DNA probe and PCR. Now, cystic sarcosis. Radio diagnosis by imaging methods. CT MRI scan detect hypodense area and hyperdense eccentric area inside the vesicle. It is shown in figure. Antigenic detection. ELISA using monoclonal T solium antibodies. Antigen disappears following treatment, hence can be used for monitoring. Figure shows biopsy from the brain HND stain. Histopathology can be detected in muscles, eyes, subcutaneous tissue by biopsy following surgical remover of FNAC of the cyst followed by microscopic demonstration of the parasite. Now, deprotodiagnostic criteria for human cystic sarcosis. It is based on clinical, imaging, immunological and epidemiological. Absolute criteria, major criteria, minor criteria and epidemiological criteria. Treatment. Now, intestinal tineasis, drug of choice is praziquintal, single dose that is 10 mg per kg is highly effective. Niclosamide 2 g is also effective but is not widely available. In cystic sarcosis, antiparasitic agents for brain parenchymal region are albendazole that is 15 mg per kg per day for 8 to 28 days, or praziquantel, that is 50 to 100 mg per kg daily in 3 divided doses for 15 to 30 days. Longer course are often needed in patients with multiple subarachnoid cysticercae. Now, surgery. Open craniotomy to remove cysticercae is rarely required nowadays. Surgery is indicated for ocular and spinal and ventricular lesion because antiparasitic drugs can provoke irreversible inflammatory damage. Prevention. Prevention is intestinal tinnitus. It is adequate cooking of beef or pork, refrigeration or salting for long period or freezing at 10 degrees centigrade for 9 days. Effective fecal disposal to prevent infection to cattle and pigs. In cysticercosis, good personal hygiene to prevent auto-infection with the eggs. Effective fecal disposal to prevent contamination of food and water with eggs. Treatment and prevention of human intestinal infections. Now treatment. Praziquantel is the treatment of choice. Niclosamide. Thank you.